Hello everyone, this is Miki from Rikenkeki. Today, I will introduce to demonstrate how acid deprivation occurs by using this acrylic box. By the way, do you know what the oxygen concentration in the air is? Yes, the oxygen concentration is 20.9% in the air. When checking it with oxygen gas detector, 20.9% is shown. Now, here is what happens to the human body when oxygen levels are depleted. An oxygen concentration of approximately 18% is considered the limit of safety. As oxygen levels gradually decrease, the human body is disturbed and symptoms such as nausea occur. If it falls below 6%, the human body is immediately affected, resulting in unconsciousness or cardiopulmonary arrest. Air and gas are invisible, so I would like to use dry ice to show how oxygen deficiency occurs. Dry ice is formed when carbon dioxide solidifies. Put the dry ice in a glass of water and place it in the box. White smoke comes out rapidly. The white smoke is water liquefied by cooling water vapor in the air. Carbon dioxide is heavier than air, so it accumulates at the bottom. The alarm of the oxygen gas detector installed at the bottom has sounded. A doll in the box is used as a worker to explain the situation. The oxygen gas detector above has not sounded its alarm because it is not at the level of the standing worker's face. Now it is visible because of the dry ice fumes, but under normal circumstances, the worker would not notice. If you drop something and bends down to pick it up, you may lose consciousness and collapse. The person who sees you and goes to help you may also suffer secondary disaster and fall as a result of an oxygen deficiency accident. So, how can accidents be prevented? The question is, how to recover from an oxygen depleted site? In short, the person ventilates it with a blower. If this is left as it is, convection and air are mixed inside, so a ventilation port is always required. It is necessary to provide ventilation openings to circulate the air inside. Gradually, the oxygen level will be restored. It's not just a prediction that you'll recover, but with a portable gas detector like this, you'll definitely check the numbers by extending the gas sampling rod. It has recovered to 20.9%. Now that the safety has been confirmed, we can finally go rescue the fallen people. Well, although it is simple, I explained about the oxygen deficiency accident. In order to prevent such accidents, it is important for workers to carry their own gas detectors and to install and use gas detectors in appropriate locations on site. In addition, assuming the possibility of falling into an oxygen deficiency state, be sure to set up ventilation opening and ventilate appropriately. In addition to the oxygen gas detector, we offer a lineup of various gas detectors. For more information, please visit to the products section of our website for more information. Thank you for watching to the end.